I think it's a fantastic opportunity for Curtin to show the state, the country, the world, that as an early adopter, this is what university should be about.
I think the moral and the safety issues of driverless vehicles is extremely important here.
Control is probably the biggest stumbling block that we're going to face in terms of human psychology and increasing the adoption of autonomous vehicles.
It's just a question of how many decisions will we let the vehicle make for us, and I think we will eventually get to a point of the vehicle making all the decisions for us.
Having an autonomous vehicle on a university provides a safe environment in which we can test this brand new technology.
We're very interested in the extent to which autonomous vehicles are going to change society as a whole, but specifically in terms of the health outcomes, and they are vast and probably completely underestimated at this point in time.
I'm really interested in people's responses to the bus and to the technology, you know, answering questions like, will they perceive it as a danger to public safety, or do they think that it's perfectly safe? How do they respond to the idea of a vehicle with clearly no driver here in this vehicle?
I like the idea of the Internet of Things driving this, because the bus can be a thing in the Internet where users can interact in a way that potentially create new business environment.
I see benefits on both sides. We get to work with the university and understand how we can solve some challenging problems that we can see within our important customers. But at the same time, the university can actually leverage a lot of the solutions that we're working with in a sort of a rapid prototype approach.
Having this kind of technology available on Curtin campus enables us to watch humans interacting with the technology. So how do they feel about the technology prior to exposure? How do they feel about it afterwards? What are the sticking points? What are the things that we need to educate them about or tell them about to enable them to be more accepting longer term of the technology?
The cars, the autonomous cars of the future, will be covered in sensors, and they will have all that information being fed into effectively a machine learning device that will make very good decisions.
So if you think about the fact that we've got about 1,200 people a year dying on Australian roads and another 35,000 or so who end up in hospital, that's, you know, close to $16 billion worth of expenditure just dealing with that road trauma. The forecasts are that when we have autonomous vehicles, they're going to all but eradicate those costs, because most accidents are the result of human error, and that human error will be taken out of the equation.
There's a lot more to it than just passenger vehicles on the road. I think if you apply the same ideas, autonomous vehicle technology, to trucks, to buses, to trains.
And with that will go all the supply chain optimization as well. So we'll become much more efficient as we how we move things around the state.
It's all about the new era of mobility and transportation. You don't have to buy car insurance anymore. You don't have to worry about parking in the big city.
The other kinds of health benefits that we're looking at are just the fact that your people who become socially isolated due to illness or age, because they can no longer hold a license, they'll actually be able to stay mobile.
Well, for a start, I think my kids are probably the last generation who'll need to get a driver's license, which has always been a bit of a teenage rite of passage, but that's gone. The school run in the morning will disappear. You'll just whistle for the car. It'll pick the kids up and take them off to school. Having to leave work early for soccer practice, all of that sort of stuff will disappear. So parents who feel like a taxi service will probably appreciate the technology.
Having that bus here gives us a great opportunity to develop new solutions, and then hopefully we can take those solutions and export them globally.